Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning. Taken from the book Straight Ahead, written by Adley A. Estep, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, Holding Grudges. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Ephesians chapter 4, verses 26-27. It says, "In your anger, do not sin. Do not let the sun go down while you are still angry. And do not give the devil a foothold." Children, did you ever get angry at someone? Maybe it was while you were playing baseball. You were at bat with two out. Two men were on base. The runner at second was one of your speediest players. If you could only hit a single, he could make it home, and your side would win, for the score was tied. It was a tense moment in the ninth inning. And then it happened. The pitcher threw a fastball, and you had to duck to keep from being hit. You just knew he was trying to knock you out. He was deliberately trying to hit you. You just knew it. In such a moment, what did you do? Maybe you didn't say anything, at least right then. But what did you think? You very likely became angry at that moment. But how did you feel about it by evening? Hopefully, you felt much calmer and had overcome your anger. Now, what counsel does the Lord give you? Read our memory verse for today. Long-standing anger toward someone is a grudge. Webster defines this as sullen malice, cherished ill will. Don't cherish malice, for malice drinks one half of its own poison, as Seneca said. Notice again that the Apostle Paul states that when you are angry and have malice or cherish still will, you will give opportunity to the devil. One famous writer put in this way, "Lust makes men brutish, malice makes them devilish. It is mental murder." What did Jesus have to say about this matter? Listen to him, the greatest teacher the world has ever known. You have heard that it was said, "Love your neighbor and hate your enemy." But I tell you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be children of your Father in heaven. He causes his sun to rise on the evil and the good, and sends rain on the righteous and the unrighteous. If you love those who love you, what reward will you get? Are not even the tax collectors doing that? And if you greet only your own people, what are you doing more than others? do not even pagans do that. Be perfect, therefore, as your heavenly Father is perfect. Matthew chapter 5, verses 43 to 48. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, are any of you currently feeling angry, disappointed, hurt, or maybe even vengeful because of something your friend or someone else did to you that offended at you? Maybe you think that it's normal when you are angry with people who hurt you. But God's word this morning teaches us how to manage our anger. Let's repeat from the first tip. When you are angry, don't sin. For example, when you are angry with your friend, don't hurt them. Second, don't save your anger until the sun sets in this heart. Third, don't give Satan a chance to tempt you to do bad things to others. Children, remember that anger, let alone revenge, will only reduce your happiness and even damage your mentality. Therefore, listen and try to practice this morning's advice that when you are angry, be quiet for a moment. Calm yourself and pray to God. Tell Him how you feel and let Him help you to be patient and not sin. Let God calm you down when you are angry. Children, I hope that today you can live your day with love and joy with your friends, your family, and especially those who hurt you. And you will be a winner today because you have a heart full of love like Jesus. May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.